So once again, we are starting with the practical of iteration. So here two, three programs we will discuss today, and one program we will discuss an easy program, but it is having the how to define the functions and all once more. Previously, I had discussed with you all, but still we need a revision on it. That's why I have decided to do a program which will be on the Python function. So let's see the first program on iteration. I had spoken to you earlier also, and this is also I'm doing right now. So what is the things? The very important two things are there. One is called range function, another is called else function, right? So else function, this else function is a very unique one in Python, because in other kind of languages and all, with the loop structure, there is no else is there. Okay, so it is available only with Python only. So that is why the iteration. So what is the thing out here? Range 5 has been given. So, and the value will be printed, and when the value will be out of range, the else block will be executed. So this else block is entirely optional. It's not mandatory, first of all. So if you require this thing, then you can introduce an else block over here. Okay, that is the thing. So let us see now the how the program is executing. Okay, now see. So the loop has executed, and the loop has been executed out here along with the range function as usual. Okay, so what is the thing? See here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, because the range is functioning as its usual course. Okay, so I'll start from 0, and unless nothing has been mentioned. Okay, so if I'm mentioning something, what will happen? Say I'm giving here 2, comma, no, I'm giving here from minus 2, suppose, minus 2, comma 5. Let's see once, that is the what is the things are happening. Okay, then I'm giving out here, okay. So that it has started from minus 2, then minus 1, then 0, comma 1, 2, 3, 4. One stop less. Okay, that is the thing. So 5, it will stop at 4. So, and when the value have come out of the range, then values have come out of the range, then in that case, what happened? The loop has completed execution. The else block has been executed. That is what the specialty of the iteration. So by changing the values, as you have seen, I'm doing, so you can also do the same thing. All right. So that's what we had discussed today. All right. So then what is happening out here? The next program, if we go, then that is a very important program. We have done it before also, maybe. I'm not sure. That's why you are doing it today. Okay. So what we will do, that is called factorial. Factorial means what? Product of the natural numbers up to that number given. Suppose if it is 5. So for example, if it is 5, I'm going to notepad once again. Suppose it is 5, then it will be resulted in this way. 5 equals to what? 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. So then what will be the output? Output will be 120. So you see out here, a product variable has been taken and it has been accumulated over here. Though even I am using out here a different kind of loop, that is called while loop actually. I less than or equals to n. And P equals to P into I, and I equals to I plus 1. So what is happening? First of all, P will be accumulated into P equals to 1. So what is happening? 1 into 1. All right. So P will have the value 1. Next stage, what will happen? 1 into what? I. I means whatever be the value of existing I, that will be increased by 1. So it will be I into 2. Okay, so value will be 2, then P equals to, again, P into I, value of P is I. Like yesterday, I discussed the sum of natural numbers in the same way. This will be 3. So it will be 6 out here, and P will be equals to 6 in, sorry, not here. It will be 6 into 6 into 4, that will be equals to 24. And P will be equals to 24 into 5, that will be equals to 120. So 120 will be the outcome. All right, now let us see and execute the program once, so you'll be able to understand it. Okay, so the thing is that suppose I'm entering 5, the same output has been generated as I have generated out here. So it was like this out here, 120, and here also it is coming as 120. That is the utility of the factorial. Okay, so that actually finding out the natural number, the product of natural number, specified natural number. I mean, say the 5 has been, if it is 6, then in that case it will be how much? It will be 720. 6 into 120 will be 720. So I would like to say you that you must do the practical. This is somehow like for loop only, but while loop is what? Same, almost same. It is functioning. Okay. So that is the thing. Clear? Once again, going back to the next program, the previous program. So how it looks like, you see out here, just factorial. Okay, so the factorial is doing in such a way that it's very easy to understand. But here I have used one construct that is actually while loop construct, quite easy also. This is the initialization of the while loop. This is the condition, and here it is being modified. So whenever it is checking I less than, suppose you have given 5, what you have given, say 5. Okay, say not this one. I'm executing the program, so you'll understand. Okay, when you are giving 5, then what is happening out here? Say 5, then n will have the value 5. Okay, so I less than or equals to 5, it will be, that means 5 times the loop will be executed. Okay, so 1 here. Okay, so what is happening? 1 is less than or equals to 5. Yes, it is true. Then this set of statements will be executed. And what is happening next? Value of I is becoming, when I equals to I plus 1, that is the main updation step. I plus 1 is 2. 2 is less than or equals to 5. Yes, that is also true. Then this set, two set of statements will be updated. So in this way, whenever the conditions are being true, the main theme of the loop for functioning, that is the, maybe the structure may vary. All right. But the main theme is that as long as condition is true, okay, as long as condition is valid, in that case, the execution also will happen. The loop will be executed, but once the condition is false, the loop will not be executed at all. That's what the thing. All right, so now we are going to a special kind of program. See, this is a very easy program to understand. Okay, and these are the types I'm showing you. See, in Java, in C++, or in this thing, what you call, in Python, a program can be written in as many number of ways you want. Okay, that's the thing. Here also a type. This is by using the least data type. Okay, so what is happening? X for X in range 20 means that whatever be the value of X, okay, that will be generated and it will be stored into NList, which is an object type. And which values are being stored? The even numbers. Okay, so if X modulus 2 equals 0, then in that case, what will happen? The even numbers will get stored into the NList. Okay, so let us execute the program. You will see the how the displays are appearing, so you will understand the list type. All right. So the thing is that you see out here, it starts from 0, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, up to 18, it has been printed. So within 1 to 20, all the things have been printed. All the even numbers have been printed. Okay, so that is the thing. So if we want to change it, say odd, okay, and say odd numbers between 1 to 20, simply I will make it here odd. And here what is happening, whenever you are dividing an odd number by 2, then the remainder becomes 1. That's the logic has been used. In case of an even number, the remainder returns 0. So that's why the for x for x in range 20, only those values to be printed which are having the remainder as 1, means they are not exactly divisible by 2. Okay, when a number will be exactly divisible by another number, so the remainder will become 0. So in that way, we find out the multiples and all. Okay, so here also the same thing, we have just sorted out those values which are having the remainder as 1. And the main logic is what? Embedded into it what? And whenever a number to be divided by 2, then the remainder will be 1. All right. So that logic we will incorporate out here. So I'm executing the program and running the module. Executing the module, you see out here what is happening. Previously, it has been printed the even numbers. Now it has printed the odd numbers. So in this way, different types of values can be changed. Suppose if you're talking about the multiples of 3, display the multiples of 3. Okay. How to do? Multiples of 3. All right, now let us see the same program I'm making out here, how to do these things, you see. Okay, so you check out here. So nothing I've changed much. Only the thing is that I will make here 3, because when any number is divisible by 3, if it's a multiple of 3, say for example 12, the remainder will become 0. So I'm making 0 out here. So run, executing the module, okay, clicking on it, you see. The 0, 3, 6, 10, 12, 15, 18 has come. Other numbers have not been displayed. So in this way, we have filtered out the value, extract the value, and we have printed. So a same program can give you the different outputs unless slight change is required. So that's what the utility of practicals. All right. So that's why I'm saying all the time, every tutorial I have told you, you must practice the video. Practice the practical implementation. That is very, very important. Okay, now you see the thing is that another program is here. that is the function. All right, so this is a simple function where I will discuss it in my coming next video. All right, welcome to this particular program. This is actually a function. Last time we had discussed the function also. I had given also revision notes on function, but if you have implemented it well, then it will be easy to understand. So you see here what happened. I'm doing a very simple program, three numbers using function, that can be done without function also, but this is a different kind of structure by using the def and user defined function sum. And within that sum, these three values that you can see, these are the arguments. Okay, these arguments have been passed, and then these arguments value, copy of the value has been sent it over here, sum has been calculated and it has been printed. And this is the last line that you can see. This is called function call. Whenever you are building a function, in that case you have to call that function, otherwise of no utility. All right, so I'm executing this program and see out here what is happening. So the thing is that the main thing is that to understand the function, functions may be with parameter, without parameter also. So the parameter that we will have, these are called formal parameters, means it have some, where it has some meaning over there. But unless you are supplying anything over there, okay, then what will happen? It has no meaning. So it is just formally printed. Like suppose if you are going to the market, you have kept a bag with you, a wallet. Okay, in the wallet no money is there, then without the money, wallet is meaningless. That's the thing. So what is happening? I have kept out here, okay, the value. If I am not entering the value, sum will not take place. So what is happening now? This values I am printing. So enter first number. So I say I am printing 5. I am sending 5. So 5 will be copied into A and it will be sent to the expression. All right. Then I am second number. I am 7. Then second number that B will accept it and it will be sent to the expression. And I am entering now 8. Okay. Then what is happening? 8 will be copied into C and it will be finally send it to expression. Okay, then expression will have 3 values, 5 plus 7 plus 8, and the sum will be accumulated or calculated or computed and it will be printed. All right, now you see the sum has to, sum is 20, quite correctly has been appeared. So this is the output. So here what is happening? So whenever you are calling this function, that will ask you to enter a value and those values have been copied, means from accepts by n1 and copied into A, sum has been calculated, accepts in n2, copied into B. So then what is happening? What this 5, 7, 8 are? 5, 7, 8 are the actual argument. Okay, that is the argument, we can say they are the actual parameters. So the thing that the parameters that you are representing in a user defined function are called actual parameter and formal parameter. And when we are getting the values, when we are sending the values, those are called argument or actual parameter. So formal parameter, actual parameter, there is a difference. So that is the main thing in the function. Okay, so whenever you will write a function, definitely try out each and every program with a function. Okay, that is give you a very modular approach into the field of programming. That's the thing. So you implement the practical nicely, and I would like to say that practical is the base of any programming language. Unless being with the practical, only theory will not do. That's why I am demonstrating you these practicals in the YouTube link, and asking you and urging you to do this practical in your system by installing the Python XY or by using the normal Python as well. Okay, so thank you. Carry on the practical very nicely.